we're about ready to get started here. Lawrence Welk, are you ready over there?
Yes, Jack.
How about Betty White? Is she here?
I'm all ready, Mr. Miner.
Fine, Betty. Byron Nichols. Byron Nichols around here anywhere?
I'm over here, Jack. We're ready to roll.
Well, I see there's Hartzell and there's Lou. I guess that's about everybody. Thank you very much.
Plymouth, your star of the forward look, welcomes you to your special Plymouth sales meeting. And here is your host, Plymouth Vice President in charge of sales, Mr. Jack W. Miner.
Good afternoon, gentlemen, and welcome to what we feel will be a very important and an entirely new experience in factory and retail sales teamwork. Now, this is, first of all, just for the record, not a dealer meeting. Now, we're very happy to have all our wonderful dealers with us today, but this is actually Plymouth's very first meeting aimed directly at the salesman, to let you retail salesmen know our dependency on your ability, our dependency on your production, and more important than all, our interest in your earning power. This is kind of a first person-to-person Plymouth sales conference that we know you'll want more of in the future. Now, since we're all Plymouth salesmen together, it is my opinion that we have a lot of things in common, things that we can do to assist each other in doing a better job of merchandising our great Plymouth, things that, if we approach them in complete sincerity, can add more money to your pockets. Now, while we were in the process of getting this meeting together, we approached it from the position that if I, Jack Miner, were sitting out there where you're sitting right now, and believe me, I wish I were, everything that was said and done on this telecast must be aimed right straight at me in such a way that I could sell more cars and I could make more money. Now, as a salesman, I didn't come to this meeting just to be entertained. I came for help, for information, for selling ideas. In fact, I came for a fresh look at my job and my opportunity. Now, we believe that's what you're looking for. And believe me, we're going to do our level best to see that you get it. So, to start this meeting off, we decided to bring to the stage today the newest, perhaps the greenest Plymouth salesman that we could find anywhere in the country. And we're really going to give him an education today. And here he is, the newest, most uninformed salesman on our team, greater than ever and raring to go for Plymouth, Bob Hope.
Hey, old boy. Thank you.
Robert, let me welcome you to the Plymouth sales staff and say to you that we're mighty happy to have you a part of our team.
Well, thanks, Dad. You know, it's a kick to be with such a swinging group with new ideas and new everything. And, you know, there's only one feature you've retained, but it happens to be the one I like. Money.
I see you retained.
Now, I'm only kidding, Jack. The 58th Plymouth is the greatest. Of course, you know, I used to be on for Chevrolet. You don't mind, do you?
Absolutely. You know, Bob, you're just one of many, many people that have switched from Chevrolet to Plymouth.
He's a sly one, isn't he, huh? No, you know, before Chevrolet, Jack, I was on for Pepsodent. In fact, they gave me this set when I left. The gums are mine, by the way. We're not on the air, are we?
Don't worry, Bob. This is a closed-circuit telecast, so you can just say anything you want to all our dealers and salesmen out there.
Closed circuit. That's TV talk for shut the door, mother, while we tell the boys how to beat the stuffing out of the kids next door. How many of the boys here do you figure looking in, Jack?
Well, right now in 41 cities, we probably have about 28 to 30,000 people out there.
Is that right?
And they're the greatest salesmen and dealers in the world, and I'd like for you to say a few words to them.
Oh, thank you very much, Jack. Thank you, and good evening, iron traders. I just want to say welcome to Chance of a Lifetime for you and to me. Now, it's a pleasure doing business with an honorable gentleman like Jack Miner. Although, when we first discussed terms, he did try to lowball me. He's not a bad salesman either. He made a deal with me, and it's one simple paragraph. I looked at it again this morning. One simple paragraph and 90 pages of accessories. This show is one of them. Now, you notice I've already discovered that you car salesmen have a language all of your own. For instance, I never knew a ragtop was a convertible. I always thought it referred to Bing's head. His top comes down too, you know. And a tire bump pump deal is where they raise the trade-in allowance and the asking price at the same time. Of course, in TV, it's just the opposite. When your rating goes down, they let the air out of your head. But Jack has been wonderful to me. The day I signed, he gave me a brand new Plymouth, a Sally Rand. If I make good here, I get the keys. Anyway, for me, it's nice to be working again. This is the longest job I've had lately. Now I know why they call it Plymouth. A whole new way of life has just opened up for this pilgrim. Seriously, it's wonderful to be working again. For a while there, I felt like Marshal Zhukov. They sent him up to walk the dog, you know. I took advantage of my vacation. I just returned from two glorious weeks at the unemployment office. They were three deep at the comedian window. And I didn't mind telling you, it was a little nerve-wracking. Do you know what it's like sitting around night after night all made up and no place to go? I even had to pass up a guest shot while I was out of work. I was going on What's My Line, but nobody could figure out what my line was. But it's nice to be working again. I hope it's nothing temporary. And it looks like it might last. Last night, Gleason and Caesar stopped smiling at me. And just so you don't get the wrong impression that my ex-sponsor and I are on the best of terms, that we really are. In fact, they asked me to wear one of their watches while they're testing it, the one they tow under the Atlantic. Of course, it's just one of those seasons. I guess this is the second, third time I've made a comeback this year. I've made more comebacks than a bowling ball. No, a lot of people aren't on TV. There's Bishop Sheehan. He's a big hit on TV. He's off this year. And look at the sponsor he had. I've always liked him on television. He's always had a kind word for me. In fact, after my last show, he had two. Keep praying. And I hear he's coming back in a Western. The sheriff of Vatican City. I can just see him walking into town saying, all right, I'll give the Protestants 24 hours to get out. I think he's just wonderful on television. I really do. And he's got some great stories. He told me a wonderful story about these two prospectors up in Alaska that ran into a terrific blizzard, and one started to die of exposure and said to his friend, rush quickly and get me a priest. And this fella staggered through this blizzard and finally got to the priest's house and said, come, my friend is dying of exposure. And the priest said, I doubt if the dogs will make it. But he hooked up the dogs, and they finally got through this blizzard and got back to this poor fellow. And he leaned over to give him the last rites, and he said, what is your name? And the fella said, Ginsburg. Ginsburg, and you sent for a priest? The fellow said, you don't think I'd ask a rabbi to come out in a night like this? And I hope he's back on TV soon. You know, I've been very fortunate in my career. I've stolen from so many sponsors. I was with Lever Brothers for 10 years. I was with Chesterfield for 5. I was on for Chevrolet for 2. And 1 hour with Timex. I don't like the way the wind is blowing. I think they may be grooming me for station breaks. I'm not sure. So you can realize my enthusiasm for being here for Plymouth. And of course, I know a little bit about the car business myself. My brother just bought a Kaiser Fraser agency. Pretty hep kid. The deliveries are kind of slow, but it doesn't bother him. Most of his customers live in Pasadena, and they're not pushing him. I'm especially proud of my brother Jack, though. 2 weeks ago, he didn't know a Plymouth, the hole in his Edsel. I like the front of that, Edsel. It looks like it just took a broma seltzer and is trying to burp. And I don't say that because I'm working for this sponsor. I'm very happy to be with Plymouth. That's, you know, one of the... I've only been with Plymouth a week, and what a great outfit. I've had a free tune-up, 1,000-mile checkup, and they boiled out my carburetor. Next week, I'm taking in my car. I can stare, too, you know. No, I've learned from experience that the Plymouth people are the friendliest in the world. I've had my new car for a week, and I still can't get the salesman out of the back seat. Or my wife. The bank owns the pink slip on both. Now, I have found out that the Plymouth people, when they put a car together, it stays together. I know because I come from California where we take them apart. No, I buy a new car every year. I have to. I can't afford a used car. And it must be gratifying to know that you bring pleasure to so many people. To some guys, buying a new car is as exciting as going out with a new girl. And with some dealers, the result is the same. I think the automobile industry is one of America's proudest. Here, everybody owns a car. In England, it's only for the rich. In Italy, you're lucky if you own a bicycle. In Russia, you have to be a dog to go anyplace. But it's amazing what mass production and nationwide distribution can do. In what other country can 50 million people climb into their own cars and drive to the bank to make the payments? That's pretty nice. And of course, I know you fellas will take over the car market like Grant took Crosby. He's a great friend of the families, and he went to school with a general. And now that we're all members of the same family, I hope you'll feel free to visit me at my home if you're ever out this way. The address is 10346 Moore Park in North Hollywood. Don't even bother to knock. Just put your quarter in the turnstile and walk right in. Thank you. Not everybody can afford a clock like that, you know that.
You brought it with you?
Yes, sir, relatives.
Let me say this to you. We have another real great salesman for Plymouth, and I understand that he's an old buddy of yours. He's the gentleman that plays that wonderful champagne music, and here he is, Lawrence Welk.
I knew you'd be...
It's nice to see you, Bubbles.
Well, thank you very much. I knew you'd be with us sooner or later.
Well, how's that?
Well, what other comedian has this forward look?
Woo-hoo! That's quite a salami knife you're wearing there. See you later, Lawrence. I just want to say it's a pleasure to meet the nation's most popular orchestra leader.
Well, thank you very much, Bob. Thank you.
And say hello to Mrs. Lombardo.
Certainly brainwashed that fellow. Today is a very lucky day for all of us Plymouth salesmen. So we salute you with a special arrangement featuring the little champagne lady Alice Lawn, Dick Dale, and all the champagne music makers. The song, This Is My Lucky Day.
I'll say I'm lucky, this is my lucky day. Now I'm in clover, I'm glad all over, I wanna shout hooray.
I found a horse, you couldn't go wrong, and then of course you happened along. Oh boy, I'm lucky, I'll say I'm lucky, this is my lucky day.
You're lucky, I'll say you're lucky, this is your lucky day. Now you're in clover, cause folks all over are going Plymouth way.
You got the car that's 3 years ahead. You're gonna knock the other two dead. Because our salesmen are great men, really first rate men. This is your Plymouth, yeah.
Robert, how do you like that bubble effect?
Oh, that's wonderful. He's the only band leader who can do a number in his laundry at the same time.
Let me say to you in all seriousness that this gentleman has sold a great many Plymouths for us.
I know that. Well, here's hoping that you'll say the same about my old granddad jokes, huh? And by the way, Jack, now that I'm going to start selling Plymouths next Sunday night, I'd like to know more about the product. That's an old rule for salesmanship, you know. Know your product. I've made it a rule ever since I was on For Instant Girls. Seriously, Jack, what's with the 58 Plymouth? What's the story this year? I hear a part of it is the prices, right?
Well, that's a big part of the story for you to know and also for every one of you out there. You know, this year you have one of the strongest selling weapons ever used in a Plymouth showroom. Competitive pricing. More competitive, perhaps, than even you realize. In years past, I'm sure that you've heard comments like these.
Why does your car cost more than a Ford?
But I can get a Chevy cheaper.
Why, the other car was $65 less.
I don't think I want to pay the difference.
Look, mister, if you can't beat their price...
Don't give me that. I got the other car's prices.
Well, gentlemen, that's the sort of thing that you can file and forget. The price gap is closed. The competitive position that you want for Plymouth is here. This year, the same money buys any low-priced car. And this afternoon, we're going to prove that statement to you. You know, you can give your customers Plymouth styling, Plymouth value, Plymouth reputation, in many important models for less money than comparable competitive models. Now, through practically our whole line, Plymouth brings you a competitive price structure that gives you the best opportunity for conquest sales of any year in Plymouth history. Even our competitors are not completely aware of the full strength of our selling position. Now, you men know better than anyone else that no one sells a line of cars. You sell a car, and you sell it against your competitor across the street, car for car. Now, come with me to see a powerful demonstration based on actual factory retail prices of what I mean by being competitive. I'm going to use this scale to size up these models the same way that many of our customers size up their cars, by the price tag. And gentlemen, this is no malarkey. We're not going to take the odd models of the line. We're going to take the real popular body styles and stack them up against the same models of Ford and Chevrolet. So let's bring them on. First, our Belvedere V8 against Chevrolet's Bel Air four-door sedan V8. Last year, you knocked the spots off of them against a $64 advantage in their direction. All right, what are you going to do this year with that gap narrowed to just a $5 bill? $5. Why, that wouldn't even buy electric windshield wipers like Plymouth's. And all of the competitors in the low-price field charge much more than that for their electric wipers. Now let's leave that Belvedere up there and bring on that Ford Fairlane 500 sedan. This year, Plymouth sells for $14 less than the Ford Fairlane 500. That's right. The Plymouth buyer is $14 money ahead, even forgetting that the Ford buyer is getting their second-rate suspension system. Next, the Plaza 6 against the Delray 6 four-door sedan. The car that helped Chevrolet get the lion's share of that lucrative six-cylinder car market. Well, this year, that spread is $19. Now, let me ask you this. Look at those two cars. Now, if you were a buyer, would it be worth 25 cents a week to move up from that boxy, as they ought to say, too true to be new Chevrolet to a Plymouth? Gentlemen, go get them. There's nothing to hold you back. Now let's try our Savoy V8 against the Ford Fairlane V8 four-door sedan. Last year, you men did a great job of selling our Savoy four-door against the comparable four-door Ford with a price differential of $34 against you. This year, look what's happened. That $34 has narrowed down to a measly $3 less at retail. But wait a minute. What a phony that is. If we're going to match them comparable model for comparable model, let's match them comparable ride for comparable ride. Now that Savoy has our top suspension, torsion air. So why shouldn't we match the price of the Ford Fairlane with its top suspension, air spring? When we do that, you really clobber them with a $145 price advantage. Now here's our Belvedere V8 convertible compared with the Ford Fairlane 500 V8 convertible. What's the story? Plymouth, $21 less at retail. Here's your price advantage to move in on the car that boasts about being the champ of the convertibles. But even the so-called champ cannot match Plymouth's windshield. This compound windshield is not only the largest in the low price three, but its contour to the left and right and overhead provides the greatest safety vision in the industry. Now, our deluxe V8 two-door six-passenger station wagon against the Ford Ranch Wagon. Yes, sir, they've got us. A whole $25, about 1% of the total cost of either car. And for that 1%, you can offer your customers the longest wheelbase and the biggest two-door station wagon in the field. The same holds true for the Chevrolet four-door six-passenger Nomad wagon against our four-door V8 six-passenger Sports Suburban. $36 is the difference. And gentlemen, if our styling isn't worth $36 more than that crazy mixed-up Chevrolet wagon, I'll eat it. Now I want to do something strange, and it's just to point up how little that $36 means. Here it is. We've got in our four-door nine-passenger Sports Suburban the most expensive station wagon in the low-price field. A real luxury wagon at a luxury price. We couldn't build enough of them last year to meet the demand. Chevrolet didn't even try to build a nine-passenger wagon in their price class. And believe me, they're smart. Last year, they just barely moved their Brookwood nine-passenger that retails for more than $200 less than our big wagon. Why didn't they try to market one against our Sports Suburban? Because our wagon, mounted on its 122-inch wheelbase, the longest in the industry, offers so many great features of luxury and comfort and convenience that even the $200 difference can't put them in competition. You know, I'd almost offer $200 to a salesman who could figure out how anybody is meant to get into the third seat of that Chevrolet monstrosity. We'll take a look at what I mean a little later. Right now, let's stack up our Belvedere V8 two-door hardtop side by side with the Chevrolet Bel Air V8 two-door hardtop. You know that last year this model was one of our hottest selling jobs in conquest sales on Chevy, even giving away $59. This year, that price margin melts away to a slim $15 at retail. And for $15, you're going to take a real bite out of that Chevy market. All right, hold that Belvedere and bring on the Ford Fairlane 500 V8 two-door hardtop. You know, I almost feel ashamed of this because I don't see how anybody could look at the Ford twice, even if it cost $50 less. Somebody apparently used a can opener on the hood. Never mind, let's look at the price difference. And it is just $4 difference. And get this, Plymouth is not $4 more, it's $4 less than the best Ford has to offer. Now our Belvedere four-door V8 hardtop against Chevrolet's Bel Air four-door V8 hardtop. Chevrolet gets a $21 nod. But get this. This is the same Chevrolet model that last year took a real beating when the difference between the two models was not $21, but $63. So this year, we've cut that difference one-third. All right, bring on the Ford Fairlane 500 four-door hardtop. Ford's big volume should give them a big price. advantage. What'll it be? $20? $30? Let's watch the scale. Whoop, did it wiggle? Yes, for two measly dollars, right on the nose. That's the advantage.
What you've seen so far proves that with our 1958 Plymouth, you've got competitive price right down the line. And all these prices, mind you, are based on standard, not on optional equipment. Speaking of standard equipment, you all know that the new chrome trim on our Plaza models is standard this year. Now, some of our Plaza models have been shipped without this trim. So right now, we're sending this trim free of charge to the dealers with these cars, and the factory will pay an appropriate labor cost for the installation. Gentlemen, with this standard trim on your Plaza, you will have greater sales appeal than you've ever had. So let's not overlook the six-cylinder market. Last year, Chevrolet got the lion's share of that big market. And this year, the industry will sell in excess of 1 million six-cylinder cars. Let's get our share of that big market. On any model in any line, you're selling Plymouth this year on even terms with the competition. You'll find that prices have been lowered on exterior paint, trim, and other optional equipment. So this year, it can be said without any doubt that the same money buys any low-priced car. And this gentleman will be regarded in the automobile industry as the most significant fact of the 1958 model year. That Plymouth, with its tremendously improved quality, will compete price-wise with the volume giants Ford and Chevrolet. But you know, the final and the most impressive part of your new price story has yet to be told. It concerns a model that you received most enthusiastically at our recent announcement meetings, and that's our great Savoy two-door hardtop. We reminded you at the time that hardtops are now accounting for 1 out of 4 of all automotive sales. And we predicted that our new Savoy line would account for many, many sales in 1958. But there was one thing that we didn't know about this model. But we know it now, and it's the biggest price story of the year. And gentlemen, it's your story. This year, in this model, the Plymouth Savoy two-door hardtop, you've got the lowest priced hardtop in America. And here it is, America's lowest priced hardtop, with our good friend Lou Crosby to tell you about it.
Hi, you guys. Hiya. As usual, it's wonderful working with you. I'm with you. And over here, this is the car. Plymouth Star, the lowest priced hardtop in all America. And today, this car becomes a symbol of the opportunity for each and every salesman watching this show. And those home mind in the store, too. This Savoy two-door hardtop can be your meal ticket for 1958. This is the baby that'll buy the shoes for Papa. Look at that. Wouldn't that ring your cash register? When we tell your prospect that this is America's lowest price hardtop, we're not talking about pennies or nickels or quarters. We're talking about dollars and lots of them. It's Plymouth Savoy two-door hardtop sells for $104 less at retail than the lowest price Chevrolet hardtop. And this Savoy hardtop model sells for $49 less than the comparable Ford hardtop. And your Savoy is also the lowest price four-door hardtop. $98 under Chevrolet and $44 under the Ford Fairlane V8. You got a lot to sell in this beauty. The lowest priced hardtop in America. Now let's take a look at some of its features. Torsion air ride. No extra cost. Dual headlight. Now look at that grip. Clean, massive, and powerful. Total contact brakes. Yours at no extra cost. But look at that style. That is Plymouth Silver Dart styling. That's the long, low look of motion. And for people who travel, for people who don't, this big, big Plymouth trunk, mighty, mighty handy. Bigger than Ford's, bigger than Chevrolet's, this is the biggest trunk in the low-price street kit. Let's take a look, huh? Look at that. Thank you.
it's up to you. Sell more Plymouths every day.
We've got more features to sell. Style that's wanted today. Price that you want to yell. Don't let a live one get away from Plymouth.
Car that's ahead for keeps. That's what we said for keeps. Plymouth will lead in every way. Plymouth offers a ride so rare.
You will find a system really complete. Ford and Chevy's behind, pushing airbags that can't compete
with Plymouth. Torsionaire costs no more. Tell them it costs no more. Plymouth will lead in every way. Plymouth, start on the forward look.
About that round the world trip, investigation reveals Ford went mostly by ship. We went twice as far and we did it on wheels.
In Plymouth, you can't go wrong this year. One thing is very clear, better have your order book.
Trump show packs a punch, and you know it's music to my ears.
Robert, what do you think of that spacious trunk?
Oh, that'd come in handy if you couldn't get a room, huh? Isn't that nice? Say, incidentally, Jack, what's this door prize that I've been hearing about today?
Well, you've been looking at it, actually. Some lucky man in one of the 41 cities is going to win America's lowest price hardtop.
No kidding. Well, I hope it goes to some deserving guy. Someone who really needs it, like an Edsel dealer or something?
No, it's for Plymouth dealers and for salesmen only. Now, the names of the cities in which the ones that are watching this closed-circuit telecast are on cards in this drum. Uh-huh. Now, what we have to do right now is to draw the name of the winning city. Now, would you mind turning the crank and I'll pick the winner?
This here?
That's right.
I haven't done this since I had my Stutz Bearcat.
I'll pick the winner.
You're going to pick the winner?
Yeah. All right.
I think we better think it over.
Why is that?
It's not that I don't trust you, but you look like a fellow that sold me 500 shares in a marmalade mine. Well, I think we ought to get somebody we can depend on here, somebody a little honest. Alice, would you join the group?
Yeah, huh? I do for you.
Sit right in the middle. We'll make a girl sandwich.
What we'd like to have you do, Alice, is to reach in there and pick a card.
All right.
And after you pick this card, we want you to go on the telephone and call the winning city, because they have already pinned up a card that has the man's name on the card that will win this great two-door hardtop Savoy. That's America's lowest price hardtop.
Oh, I know.
Now,
wonderful. Wouldn't it be nice if I pick one from Texas?
Well,
if you pick one from Texas, we're dead.
If you pick one from Texas, it's going to be an investigation. Is that where you're from, Texas?
That's right.
You can always tell a gal from Texas, but not much. You know they got a 5-day week down there now?
What? How's that?
Some rich oil man bought Saturday and Sunday. You heard.
We don't have too much time. Reach in there and you pick the name of the... there's one thing very important. Don't show Bob or myself the name of the winning city. Only you will know that.
I have a brother who's a Plymouth dealer in Cleveland, if you're...
Now, will you pin that right up there so that nobody else can see it?
Could I take a little peek at it?
Later.
Later? Promise.
You go off and make...
You mean this whole thing is honest?
Absolutely.
How'd I get sucked into a thing like this?
In a few minutes, we're going to reveal the winner's name. But right now, we're going to introduce you to a brand new TV quiz show. and our good friend George Fenneman, who you all know is on the Groucho Marx DeSoto Plymouth Show, was going to take part, but unfortunately George is ill today, so our good friend Lou Crosby has consented to pinch hit for him. Lou, take it away.
The Amalgamated and Fair Testing Research Corporation of America presents television's newest quiz show, Put Up or Shut Up. Thank you very much. Good afternoon, friends. Welcome to Put Up or Shut Up. Now, our contestants for today's show have been chosen from among the nation's finest automobile salesmen. In fact, we have three of the top sales producers here with us, so let's meet them. Sir, may I ask your name?
Joe Bradley.
And you sell?
Chevrolets. Been selling Chevrolet since 1947.
This gentleman?
Fred Carter.
Your line is?
I sell Ford.
And your name, sir?
My name's Hartzell Wilson, and I sell Plymouth.
Thank you, Mr. Wilson. I believe you men all understand the rules of our game, that put-up-and-shut-up game, and I'll ask a question about the cars in the low-price field. Each of you answer it. Now, the man who puts up evidence to support his answer gets 5 points, which I'll show on these cards right here. And I'll start at zero. After the game is over, the contestant who has the most points wins our secret prize package. Are you car experts ready?
Sure, sir. Ready
to go. Well, the first question I have here on the card is, which car has the best performance, put up or shut up?
Oh, that's easy. It says right here that Chevrolet is the NASCAR champion. And this year we've got the new and bigger Super Turbo Thrust engine.
Chevy was the NASCAR champion. This year, Ford offers a new engine, the biggest in the low price field. The Interceptor 352 Special. And you can get it on Fairlane, Fairlane 500s and wagons.
Well, gentlemen, I can't admit that I conform to the history of this thing, but I will have to admit that I've been outmeasured by 2 cubic inches. But on the road today, I've got that brand new Golden Commando V8, and it's available in any Plymouth. And gentlemen, it'll blow any Ford or any Chevrolet right off the road.
I thought we had to have factual...
Please, gentlemen. Hartzell, you'll have to put up or shut up.
Well, I can put up, Lou. Because a couple of weeks ago, we took our cars out to a proving ground for a pure test of acceleration. And the results that we found there were so amazing to us that, frankly, we went back and got 3 different cars because we just didn't believe everything was copacetic. But it was. We took a movie camera along with us and... Well, Lou, check the results for yourself. Here they are. From left to right, you have there the Chevrolet Impala, the Plymouth Belvedere, and the Ford Fairlane 500. Now, each car is equipped with its most powerful engine and best transmission, and like I said, there's no catching Plymouth. It makes like Sputnik and kisses every one of them goodbye. And listen, along with that go power, Lou, don't forget that Plymouth is the defending champion of the mobile gas economy run.
Well, the facts seem to favor Plymouth, Hartzell, so you get 5 points for performance.
Thanks, sir.
Well, now, car buyers are interested in durability, too. So the next question is, which of you is selling the most durable product, put up or shut up?
Now, that's where I really shine. Everyone knows that Ford was proved and approved in a run around the whole wide world. Now, just give me 5 points.
Hold on, Fred. Now, Joe, what do you have to say about Chevrolet durability?
My cousin, Aardvark Entwistle, he's been driving the same Chevy for 5 years, and it hasn't needed much work.
Oh, now, please, fellas, come. Joe, has Chevrolet done anything to really prove the durability of its car and product?
Well, of course. Chevrolet's almost too new to be true.
Hard. He might have said it was too new to be proved. And, gentlemen, I submit that the 1958 Plymouth made the most rugged durability run in history. 58,000 miles in 58 days. And that's equal to 2 1/3 times around the world at the equator. And there were no relaxing ocean voyages to break up the grind.
All right. But Plymouth didn't climb the Alps or go through the jungles of Cambodia.
What? Just what in the world do the jungles of Cambodia look like, Mr. Carter?
Well, any other jungle, I guess. You know, the trees and snakes. Well, you know, you've seen one jungle, you've seen them all.
Lou, while that Ford was wandering around where Fords will seldom, if ever, be driven, Our 1958 Plymouth proved itself in the highways, the mountains, and the plains of America, where plenty of Plymouths will always be driven. Gentlemen, I call that a realistic test. And I'd like to remind you, there were 58,000 miles in just 58 days.
Well, Hartzell, Plymouth put up, and the others have to shut up. And Hartzell Wilson's total is now 10 points. To our next question here. Which car has the best transmission? Put up or shut up?
Chevrolet has Turbo Glide. No jerky shifts. Why, it's as smooth as cream.
Ford's got the brand new Cruise-O-Matic, ushering in a bright new era of breathtaking, spine-tingling performance. And with our new drive range, it always starts in low.
What do you mean? Gentlemen, as far as I'm concerned, Plymouth of its torque flight has always started in low. It's available on any Plymouth V8, while Cruise-O-Matic, as you well know, is strictly limited. But the real test, fellas, is on the road, where a Plymouth of torque flight will outpull any Ford or any Chevrolet.
Yeah? Put up or shut up.
All right, brother, we'll put them up then to a real tough test. Now, this hill you see right here would give a mountain goat butterflies. Watch it. There he goes, all the way down. That's your Plymouth, friends. Be proud of it. There she is. Now, let's turn around and bring that Plymouth back up again. Watch that Plymouth with torque flight. Come back up that same hill. Now, here we have a chance where it works against a Chevrolet with Turbo Glide. Watch them take this mountain in drive range, and here they come. And there comes your Plymouth, gentlemen, and goes right out of the picture. Now, let's take another look at that Plymouth with a Ford with Cruise-O-Matic. Now, incidentally, all of these cars are the top engine jobs, and they have the same acceleration proficiencies that we had in the earlier show. Now, look at the difference. Here it is. Your Plymouth's outside, and we're waiting for competition. You know, there's such a big difference that we decided to start this Plymouth behind the Chevrolet. Watch it now. We're coming up, passing him on the hill. One-way road. Watch out. Sorry, friends, but we had to drop the Chevrolet back just a little bit in order for the Plymouth to get in. Now, let's look at the same test against Ford. Watch him. He's coming out now, beginning to mount the hill, coming around, full steam ahead, and he gets back in before we hit the crest. You know that Ford there, Lou, not only had Cruise-O-Matic drive, it was an Interceptor special, and it had everything in the world working for him except Mike Todd.
Well, it looks like our Mr. Wilson has a running start toward another win. But what about the other feature of a good transmission? Which of you sells the car with the best engine braking?
Chevrolet. We tame the hills with Turbo Glide. It's the only transmission with a grade retarder range, made just for engine braking.
How about Ford, Mr. Carter?
Well, Ford, the car that's proved and approved around the world, has, well, we have a low range that's as low as a Brooklyn Dodger fan without an airline credit card.
Well, Lou, my esteemed opponents sound very much like an ad man's dream of paradise. But holding back on hills is one test where Plymouth intentionally comes out behind. And all with just a gentle push of a button. Now, incidentally, Ford's higher-priced sisters, Edsel and Mercury, have made push button conveniently available. But Ford and Chevy, well, they're still stuck with those sticks. But why argue about downhill braking? Let's take a look and watch for a second. With a Plymouth in low range and a Chevrolet in grade retarder, here they are. They're lined up behind the camera. Engines are idling. Drivers release their brakes slowly. They're off. And there she is. Plymouth holding back right. Now, let's take that Plymouth with torque flight. Does a great retarding job against that grade retarder itself. But what about Cruise-O-Matic Ford? Look at it. Cruise-O-Matic's in low. But as you can easily see, gentlemen, I think you'll agree that Plymouth goes down that hill a lot easier and a lot safer.
Well, there's another five for Plymouth. Now, let's talk styling. Which car is the style leader? Now, we want the facts. Put up or shut up, gentlemen.
Why, there's nothing newer in the world than the new Ford. Every view is new. Every styling just, well, sings.
Oh, so does Elvis. But like I've been saying, the new Chevrolet is almost too true to be new.
Yeah, that's right.
I mean,
yeah.
Well, you know what I mean.
Yeah, we know what you mean. But, gentlemen, I'll take Plymouth's clean, classic, silver dart styling anytime against that humpy, bumpy
He's just jealous because Chevrolet's so new. The only completely new car in the low-price field.
Now, gentlemen, no wild claims, just the facts. Please, how about tail fins in 58?
Now, that's Ford. Our tail fins are just the right height. Plymouth's are too high.
Now, wait just a minute, brother. Plymouth's much-copied directional stabilizers are, well, they're not only dramatic, distinctive styling features, but they actually...
The pig's eye.
Well, we didn't copy your Plymouth fins. We copied Mercury. Original fins.
Yeah.
I think we all get the point. Have you gentlemen anything to say about the front end?
You ever seen anything newer than our beautiful honeycomb grill?
Looks like an old Buick grill to me, and I can put up these photos to show why.
Okay, wise guy. Seems like I've seen that 58 Chevy face before, too. Like on the 1956.
Well, now listen, gentlemen. You can argue, but let me tell you my impressions of these front ends. Personally, I like Plymouth's grill and because it's clean and it's got a slim hood. And that Ford and Chevrolet hood seem to drop down so far before the grills get started that, well, Lou, frankly, they kind of look boxy to me, kind of like loaves of bread.
Now, easy, hearty. You get the full score, however, for styling that's still ahead. Now, gentlemen, we've examined these cars from the outside. Let's go to the inside, shall we? Which car gives the driver the best visibility? Put up or shut up.
Chevrolet.
Well, one at a time, would you? Joe Bradley, on what do you base your claim?
Why, our literature says that Chevrolet made a terrific increase in driver visibility.
Well, so did Ford.
We didn't.
What did you say?
I said we didn't, Lou. We don't need to make any exaggerated figures about glass area. The difference is too obvious. Just take a look at these pictures and make a comparison. There's a matching view of a Plymouth and a Ford. Now, here's one of a Plymouth and a Chevrolet. You see how much more glass area we've got?
Yeah, you're right, Hartzell. We've got to score 5 for Plymouth.
Thank you.
And now, gentlemen, a question that interests a good many car buyers. Which car has the most comfortable ride? Put up or shut up?
Hey, Chevrolet, level air ride. Why, it's like riding on air. Puts a cushion of air between you and the road.
Oh, Ford Air, that's like riding on air. That puts a cushion of air between you and the road.
Now, gentlemen, I doubt very much if hot air can do the same kind of work that steel does. Tell me, Mr. Carter, have you ever tried an air spring Ford?
Well, no. You see, public demand for Ford has been so great that the frantics on the assembly basis has caused an amazing doubling of the apathy.
In other words, you ain't got any. And both of you guys are selling the best ride in two of them. This super special ride of yours, the one that obviously you're completely proud of, actually cost $130 extra.
And Plymouth?
Well, I'm kind of glad you asked, Lou, because torsion air is standard equipment from Plaza right on up to Fury. And here are the facts. A torsion air Plymouth, a Chevy with air springs, and a standard suspension Ford. Now, we had to use a standard suspension because, well, they didn't build an air spring Ford for us to test, frankly. Now, watch these rugged cars take this rugged road at 50 miles an hour. And here comes the Plymouth. Watch it closely. Levels off nice and fast. Here comes the Chevrolet, and he takes it with a little extra bounce. But look at this Ford, bouncity, bouncity, bouncity. Now let's follow these cars down the road. Keep your eye on that second car now, the Chevrolet. You can see it's going at the same speed. Now, look at it.
Great?
Sure. Now, look at the next series. The second car in this case is a Ford. And I think you'll agree with me, it looks kind of like a pogo stick following a bicycle.
I don't believe it.
Then check these matching views if you don't believe. Be skeptical if you like. Plymouth and an air spring Ford in the same position on that bump test. Both cars going 45, and the pictures are snapped with the cars at the same spot on the road as you can see. Now, maybe Brother Carter sitting over here would like to see his car stopped in midair. Now, gentlemen, that's a different Ford from the one that we used in the movie because, frankly, we thought something had gone wrong with the first one. Now, friends, according to these pictures that you've seen, the best thing that can be said for either one of the two air rides is the fact that the air ride Chevrolet is almost, and I said almost, as comfortable as Plymouth, but cost nearly $130 extra.
There's another 5 for you, Hartzell, to Plymouth. Now let's see what's next. Here's one on handling ease. Specifically, which car feels the most stable on a turn? Put up or shut up?
Now, I'm not taking any more of this jazz. Ford always has been a good car, and always will be. Why, it's been proved and approved around the world.
Man, you just can't beat air. What could be better than a cushion of air between you and the road? Air does everything. Why, air's so valuable.
Yeah, I know. I breathe a little of it every day. But let's cut off a lot of this conversation and take a look. We sent 3 cars around a curve at 65 miles an hour, which is the maximum legal speed limit in most states. Now, we'd like for you to see for yourself how they corner. with the same driver behind the wheel each time, here comes your Plymouth. Watch it. 65 miles an hour. And it takes that slight drift at this speed, but it's under perfect control, see? That's a proud beauty. Now, here comes Ford. When that rear end starts to break loose, watch the driver lose control. Goes momentarily off the road. Tough boy. But here comes that Chevy. Watch it close now. 65 miles an hour. Watch it. Easy, man. You don't get but one mistake out there.
Howdy, Hartsville. You certainly put up on that one. Now, gentlemen, tell me, what you know about the easy servicing of your favorite suspension systems? Put up or shut up.
Well, like I said, with the increasing normalcy of Ford sales reaching a new standard...
Gentlemen, no suspension is easier to service than torsionaire. Because there are only... The system is so simple that there are only 8 lube points right in the front end. It's simple.
Service? On air springs? Why, we've never had to service an air spring Chevrolet. What could happen? It's absolutely foolproof. Absolutely foolproof.
Put up or shut up, Joe.
Just a second. I'd like to put up something to the contrary, if you don't mind, Lou. Let me show you the air in air springs when it's under pressure. It can leak. Look at this one. Well, gentlemen, there's a man that's in a hurry. And he wouldn't say that air ride is foolproof. He's wasting valuable time. Watch out. Ooh, tough, huh? Yeah. Valuable time, and he can't get it over 2 inches off the ground. So what does he do? He goes and calls for the old tow truck. Now, here's the question. How is the tow truck going to lift the front end without dragging the deflated rear end? Well, just like it says in the owner's manual, fellows, you start by taking the wheels off. Now, gentlemen, Business Week magazine calls attention to the troubles of jacking up an air spring car. Now, in theory, the higher you jack, the more the air springs tend to push the tire down. You can see why we ran into. Take a look at that guy, huh? Did you know it took us 16 strokes before we could ever get that jack up high enough to see daylight under that tire? Brother, what a job.
Okay. That's 5 points for the servicing ease of torsionaire. Now, gentlemen, how about overall handling? Which car gives the safest and the most firm control? Put up or shut up.
Now, that's easy. Ford control has been proved and approved around the world. Why, from Peoria to Paris, from Rahway to Rangoon.
I'll bet a buck the only time around the world Ford put its wheels on the ground was when they saw a photographer standing by.
Now, while you two boys are bickering around, I'd like to point out that a Plymouth with full-time power steering and torsionaire could literally unravel your cars in any kind of test of control.
Oh, proof, please. Somebody's got to put up or shut up.
I'd like
any
to
volunteers?
Do it. Yeah, may I, Lou, if you don't mind. You know, we tested cars the other day by running them through a row of pylons at 60 feet apart. Here's the Plymouth coming through to establish the speed that the others will have to match. You like to travel that a little bit, Lou?
I got my hat. I'll go right with you.
That's great. Now see if the air spring Chevrolet can follow this Plymouth through. Now you see the Plymouth there? Starts to drift a little bit, but it comes back on the next turn. That's the reason for the difference. Now, look closely. Watch it.
Easy, bud.
Well, tough luck. Now, the Ford tries to follow the same Plymouth at the same speed, obviously. But what a difference. Here comes that little doll. Yes, sir. But look at this Ford. Watch this baby out of control. Watch it. He'll end up right in your lap, neighbor.
Wonderful, Hartzell. Well, as impartial as you know, I am. I'll have to say that it's Plymouth all the way, and Hartzell Wilson has a grand total of 45 points. Now, gentlemen, here is the big payoff for the winner.
Hartzell, congratulations. Let's see what you won.
Oh, thank you, Lou.
This is our secret surprise package.
This is great. Beautifully done, too, huh? Hey. Wait a minute, buddy.
Well, that's a Chevy.
And here's a Ford.
Yeah?
Well, what's the significance of these cars?
Oh, say, I see what the significance is.
These cars are symbolical of our competition that we're going to be seeing a lot of in the future on our used car lots. And I'll tell you why I'm saying this. You've seen me answering questions on put up or shut up. Well, gentlemen, here are some of the facts from an unbiased national survey that we've just received concerning persons in the market for a new car. Now, those prospects who are planning to buy a car in the immediate future, this survey tells us that over 26% want to buy a Chrysler Corporation car. But get this, more than a half, that's over 13% of them, want to buy a Plymouth.
Now, this really does open the market for conquest sales for every one of you. Gentlemen, it's our sincere belief that this afternoon you've already seen your advantages in 1958 insofar as price is concerned. These last few moments, we have done our best to punch home the superiority of your Plymouth over Ford and over Chevrolet. I wouldn't kid you for a minute. You know that. We both know that Ford and Chevys will sell, and we know that they'll sell in bunches. But there's a limit to this so-called automatic success of theirs, and that limit is you. You know, you are the most powerful offensive weapon that we, the factory, possess to fight our competitive wars for us. Frankly, the only way that we can secure conquest sales from our competition is you. So it boils down in the final answer to your strength and to your ability. Now, all of us in Plymouth are pretty proud of our retail salesmen as a whole. And actually, they're some of the nation's finest listening to me out there this afternoon. I know that because I've worked with thousands of you from coast to coast, and I've seen you produce. And we've been proud that we've been teamed together selling Plymouths. But to be perfectly honest with you, I must admit this, that there are some of our salesmen that are not going all out in their efforts to produce greater income for themselves through really hard competitive selling. Now, gentlemen, I think that you'll agree with me when I make this observation. We're all in this business of selling Plymouths in one way or another. We've all got ambitions of one degree or another to get better things out of life and to enjoy our work life just a little bit more. Now, if such be true, may I challenge each one of you out there, from the top salesman right on down the line, to make sure that your perspective is correct before you leave this meeting this afternoon. I sincerely believe that it all begins right up here. First, make sure that you like the place where you're working. That's important. Secondly, make sure that you buy the superiority of your Plymouth 100% without equation. Thirdly, make sure that you know to your own complete satisfaction that you're competitive in every way. This is all the competition has to sell against you, friends, plus his determination to beat you in making deals anywhere he can and at any time. Now, personally, I'd hate to know that I'd lose a deal or my future to a competitor that had more fight, more determination than I have. This is a great business we're in, and it's filled to the brim with opportunity for the man that knows where he's going and knows how to get there. In Plymouth, friends, your selling success is just as big as you want it to be, or as big as you want to make it. But the bigger you make it, the happier you're going to be, and the wealthier you're going to be. You've got the styling. You've got the product. You've got the price. And you've got the challenge. So, gentlemen, let's get hot. Let's get really competitive out there. Let's really sell those Plymouths in 1958.
Thank you, Hartzell, and that's a great story. And it's a powerful sales ammunition that we have in our product comparison. You know, we've just seen and understand that there is nowhere is the superiority of Plymouth's quality more evident than it is in our station wagons. The competition isn't even in the same ballpark when it comes to Plymouth. When you start comparing the features we've got to sell in our Plymouth station wagons. And gentlemen, the station wagon market is growing enormously. In fact, it has doubled three times since the war. Last year, we couldn't build enough wagons to satisfy the public demand. And this year, we know that one out of every five people will want a station wagon as their next new car. That's a big market, gentlemen. And we're real serious about getting our share of that market. Now, you can look for a very heavy advertising and merchandising campaign designed exclusively on station wagons. And to show you just one way in which we're going to help you sell more station wagons, I'm going to call on two real great people, two wonderful experienced salespeople in the Chrysler Corporation, and here they are speaking for Plymouth Mary Costa and Bill Lundegaard.
Thank you very much, Jack. It's a real pleasure to be here with you today.
Mm-hmm. And it's a pleasure to be able to grab a couple of seconds right here and now to say hello on our behalf to all of the thousands of dealers and salesmen whom we've had the pleasure of meeting in person throughout the country.
And to those of you in whose cities we haven't as yet appeared, we certainly hope to see you soon.
You know, right now, Mary and I will show you how we'll be selling Plymouth station wagons on Climax and Shower of Stars, just as you will do in your own showrooms. We'll stress Plymouth's five big station wagon exclusives.
The features that make Plymouth the best buy in station wagons, regardless of price.
Now, the first thing that anybody notices about the Plymouth station wagon is its beauty. That long, low look of motion that comes from Plymouth's years ahead style. And the next thing is the size of the Plymouth wagon. Just look at it.
It's the biggest station wagon in the low price three. In fact, you can't buy a bigger wagon at any price.
It's the biggest and the roomiest. You know, it's amazing how much more cargo space Plymouth gives you that the other two low-priced station wagons simply do not have.
Hey, Bill.
Now, yes, Mary? Tilt. Thank you. You know, this ice cube represents 1 cubic inch of cargo space. A Plymouth gives you more than 38,000 cubic inches. More cargo space than either of the other two low-priced cars. No other station wagon in Plymouth's field has this wide-view observation seat, and of course, when it's not in use, it folds flush with the floor.
And no other station wagon in Plymouth's field has a disappearing rear window right here in the tailgate. Now, on this model, the operation is electric, right at the window itself.
And the window can also be operated from the driver's seat. Of course, you get the limousine luxury of Plymouth's torsion air. This is a Plymouth exclusive in the low price field and standard equipment at no extra cost.
There you are, ladies and gentlemen. Plymouth's five great station wagon features. Five features you will find only on Plymouth in the low price field.
Biggest size? You can't buy a bigger wagon at any price. Greatest capacity of any wagon in its field? Wide view observation seat, exclusive with Plymouth in the low price three. The disappearing rear window, electrically operated from rear or driver's seat, and torsion air, yours at no extra cost.
There are 12 beautiful new 1958 Plymouth station wagon models, so why not stop in and visit your Plymouth dealer tomorrow and select the wagon that suits you best.
And whichever one you choose, you'll be ahead for keeps in a Plymouth,
the star of the forward look.
Thank you, Mary. You know, as I mentioned to you gentlemen earlier, this is to get the public thinking and wanting so they will come to you for the tough job, the really tough job, signing and sealing.
And so, success to all of you in 1958.
Costa and Bill Lundegan. Gentlemen, I told you the factory is serious about this station wagon market, and you'll be glad to know that for 1958, we've increased our production capacity for all models of Plymouth station wagons and by a wide margin. 1958, we're competitive in price, we're competitive in product, and now we're even more competitive in our lineup of station wagon models. You know, frankly, we realized this year that we needed another model to make our station wagon a completely competitive line. So today, gentlemen, we've got a new low-priced station wagon model that Ford and Chevrolet cannot match. It's our new four-door deluxe station wagon. So as of December 1st, it will be available for immediate delivery. And you can start taking orders for it now. I'm sure by now there's no doubt in your mind that Plymouth is really competitive. For 1958. Now, with the lowest priced two-door hardtop in America, with the new low-priced four-door station wagon, and with Plymouth's famous torsion air ride as standard equipment throughout, you've got a traffic building story to tell. Gentlemen, let's tell it and sell it.
Jack, I was watching that thing on the monitor. That's a wonderful wagon.
Yes, it's a great wagon. How'd you like that observation seat?
Oh, I dig that observation seat. Now your mother-in-law even has her own windshield for backseat driving. I think that's just great. Tell me, what else is new in the 58th Plymouth line?
Well, one of the very important things that we want to talk about, and believe me, there's plenty more, the subject I want to talk about right now is traffic.
Traffic. You want to talk about it or match scars?
The traffic out here rather bad?
Bad. Well, of course, it's a little better now. They've got a new law out here. No car's allowed to go over 80 miles an hour without a driver, and that's really helping.
Well, I wasn't exactly referring to that type of traffic. The traffic that we're all interested in is the type of traffic that flows into our showrooms. And I'd like to have you meet the gentleman that's responsible for making that traffic possible. And here he is, our director of advertising, Mr. Lou Hagopian. Lou, Bob Hope.
Hi, Lou. Another old-timer, huh?
Yes, sir.
You must be all of 30.
32, Robert.
32. And what do you claim?
I'm getting pretty old. I'm about 37.
37. Oh, what sneaks. This isn't an auto factory. It's a home for wayward boys. Well, as someone said, it's a youth is a wonderful thing.
I think that was Bernard Shaw, wasn't it?
No, I think it was Bing right about now. But Jack said you had something to say, Lou, so don't let us interrupt you.
Thank you, Bob. Thank you, Jack. And it's mighty important what I have to say to all of our 28,000 friends out there. Gentlemen, the facts you've heard here today will be no secret to the American public. Never before has your Plymouth advertising had such a powerful story to tell the new car buyer. The story of exclusive features, consumer benefits, actual cash savings. And it's the job of your Plymouth advertising to make sure that everybody in this country is aware of this new and important story. To get this job done, we're going to give you the most aggressive advertising program in Plymouth history. And let there be no doubt in your minds that your Plymouth advertising will be retail advertising. Retail in concept, retail in purpose. In other words, you can expect to see and hear a lot of hard sell ads. This year, you're selling America's lowest priced hardtop. Of course, we'll take this exciting story to your prospects. And you've got the strongest station wagon story in the automobile business. And of course, we'll tell this to the public. And this year, we're taking a new and direct approach to the women's market, a market never before conquered by any automobile manufacturer. We'll do this with advertising directed entirely to the nation's housewives. Plymouth quality is an important part of the story we're telling. Endurance happens to be a popular advertising theme right now with one of our competitors. We're making sure your prospects know the difference between an actual endurance grind and a round-the-world vacation cruise. All this advertising, with the merchandising and sales support that go with it, will bring prospects into your showroom throughout the year. But in addition to this, for more floor traffic during the immediate weeks ahead, we plan to bring you many, many extra prospects, legitimate prospects, right now. We have a spectacular campaign designed to do just that. And we'll put it to work for you, not next year, not next month, but next Monday. And here's how we'll do it.
A traffic builder is on the way to pack your showrooms both night and day. So listen, thanks, cause we want to say this traffic builder can be made to pay. There's lots of prizes for folks to win and 9 complete weeks to bring them in.
I just can't wait!
$500 a month for life. One of your customers will win $500 a month for life. That's the grand prize in Plymouth's Money Ahead Contest, designed to build qualified traffic for you. And listen to these additional awards. 2 Money Ahead Plymouths every week for 9 weeks. 18 new Plymouths in all, plus 450 other valuable prizes, all in this tremendous, history-making traffic builder, the Plymouth Money Ahead Contest.
Beginning Monday, November 25th, Plymouth will launch the biggest national consumer traffic building program in its history. All of the many promotional materials, such as entry blanks, Window trim and posters are on the way to you right now. Gentlemen, in big promotions of this sort, it seems that there's always somebody who just doesn't get the word. Now, we don't want that to happen here. It's important that we all understand how this traffic builder works to get the maximum benefit from it. So at this time, I'd like to present three people who sell Plymouth every week on our Date with the Angels TV show. Here are Betty White, Bill Williams, and Tom Kennedy. They're going to show you gentlemen how this contest works. So let's look in on them.
Well, Gus, that's absolutely amazing.
What's that, Vicki?
Plymouth is giving away $500 a month for life. It's a new contest.
Honey, nobody ever wins those contests.
Oh, don't be silly. Of course somebody wins. This contest has a lot of prizes, too. Look.
Hey, that is interesting.
Interesting. But that $500 a month for life is better than all your stuffy old insurance policies.
Hey, that's quite a deal at that. You know, you'd have to have over $250,000 in the bank in order to get that much money, monthly interest.
Let's go and find out more about it.
Okay. That $500 per month will bring them in. There'll be big weekly prizes also, and the contest will run for 9 weeks. We've kept it simple, easy for people to enter, and most important, this is a fun type of contest. Why do I say that? Well, because to enter, the contestant has to solve simple puzzles of the scrambled word variety. It's a game, and people like games. The puzzles spell out the names of Plymouth features, an educational plus that certainly won't do us any harm. Now let's see what happens to Gus and Vicki Angel.
Oh, it was sure nice of you folks to come in to see us this afternoon.
Well, we came in to pick up an entry blank for that new Plymouth contest.
What's this $500 a month deal?
Oh, that's one of the prizes you win in Plymouth's big money ahead contest, you see. We give away lots of prizes. As a matter of fact, two brand new Plymouths are given away every week, plus 450 other prizes. Well, how do we enter this contest? Very simple. Come right over here, I'll show you. You see, folks, all you have to do is fill out this entry blank.
Now, you don't have to give them an entry blank right away. Handle it like Tom Kennedy is doing, and you'll keep the prospect's attention.
Now, you see, the correct answer to these puzzles are important Plymouth features. And look, since I'm more familiar with Plymouth than you two, maybe I can help you out, huh?
That's very kind of you, sir. Of course, by volunteering help, you immediately put yourself on the prospect's side.
Now, of course, the best way to learn about Plymouth features is, well, to take a demonstration ride. Now, look, I have my car right outside. Why don't I take you for a drive and I can tell you more about it?
We don't have the time now, sir.
Tom Kennedy is using an excellent device to promote demonstrations. In any case, you'll get the prospect's name and address because each entry blank has a stub, which must be filled out and left at the dealership.
Well, what kind of a car are you folks driving now?
1955 Chevy.
Well, then you might be in the market for a new car. Listen, I'd like to tell you another feature of this contest. If you buy a new Plymouth during the contest period and you win one, you get double your money back.
Double our money back?
That's right. Look, how about that demonstration ride? Come on.
Of course, you won't be able to give a demonstration ride to everybody who comes in to pick up an entry blank. You know that, and of course we know it. But please keep these three points in mind, gentlemen. They're the keys to the success of this traffic building promotion. First, the unusual appeal of the grand prize, $500 per month for life. That'll attract people who are not usually interested in more conventional contests. And second, because the contest requires a measure of skill to enter, you'll get contestants of a higher caliber than the ordinary promotion. And third, to enter, contestants must be at least 21 years of age, so you won't be troubled by children. Sure, any contest offer will bring a percentage of people unqualified as new car buyers. But gentlemen, Plymouth's Money Ahead contest is designed to bring you a higher percentage of logical prospects. And if you properly put it to work for you, it will do just that. A lot of people will come in as a result of this promotion. Talk to them. Thank them for coming in. Invite them to come back. And do all that you can to sell them on Plymouth. That's the whole point of this tremendous promotion, to bring you more floor traffic so that you in turn can expose legitimate prospects to Plymouth. Add this to the terrific price and product story you've got to tell this year, and you'll have no trouble in capturing the attention of any new car prospects. You can prove to them that the same money buys any low-priced car, and you can convince them that the smart money, their money, buys the Plymouth. Thank you.
The crowds will come and you want to show the Plymouth features they want to know. Your list of prospects is sure to grow. So here's a contest for you men. Let's go, let's go!
Thank you, Lou, and let me say to you gentlemen that this will be one of the largest traffic building promotions in Plymouth's history. Make no mistake about it, we're serious about making it successful for you. You know, the most successful promotions are like a two-way street. We give you the promotion plan, adequately financed and properly executed, and you give us your active support. This traffic building promotion will convince a lot of people that they will be money ahead in a new Plymouth. This promotion will also put a lot of you salesmen and dealer money ahead if you use it properly. And now it's my pleasure to bring to you a man who is vitally concerned with our success in selling Plymouth, the general manager of the automotive group of the marketing division of the Chrysler Corporation, Mr. Byron Nichols.
And congratulations on a very fine sales meeting. And it's a real pleasure to talk to you men of Plymouth throughout the nation today. How many of you in the audience today remember a Broadway hit play, and later a movie, called The Death of a Salesman? I do, because of the title and not because it was rather a sad story. However, today I want to talk to you about the life of a salesman, and particularly the life of a Plymouth salesman. In other words, I want to talk about you, your life as a Plymouth salesman. And generally speaking, this depends on three things. Number one, the product itself, your heart, and your head. Now first, let's consider the product. If you didn't know about the 1958 Plymouth before you came here today, you do now. And what you've seen here proves that you have something to sell that is right in style, in price, in quality, and public acceptance. In every conceivable way, this new 1958 Plymouth has tremendous appeal. You've also seen today that you're getting dynamic support with a vast program of national advertising, merchandising, sales promotion, and public relation activities. From the marketing view, Plymouth and Plymouth salesmen have never had better opportunity. But, as in most things good, it's up to you and your heart and your head to prove precisely how good it can be for you. This Wall Street Journal article on new car sales is a case in point. Quote, a customer inspecting a new Plymouth in a Manhattan showroom says, the only thing new is the price and the trim. A salesman agrees. It's essentially the same car as last year, with only a few changes here and there. Now, if our Plymouth salesman said this, his head and heart were barely in motion. He missed the best opportunity, a golden opening, to sell a new 1958 Plymouth. What would you have said? What would you have done to get this customer in a new Plymouth? A right salesman, a man proud of his product and proud of his own ability to sell it, would seize this opening like an all-American quarterback. He would tell the customer everything positive about the new Plymouth, about the feel of the torsion air ride, the pride of ownership a man feels sitting behind the wheel of a sleek 1958 Plymouth. And he would have told the customer how Plymouth is still the leader, that all other competitors are trying but failing to catch up. And he would prove his points by a demonstration. In essence, today your life as a Plymouth salesman is to tell and sell and demonstrate the story of your product. Tell it and retell it to your neighbors and friends, to your relatives, and to your would-be customers, whenever and wherever you meet them. And as a Plymouth salesman, You can sell your way to the things you want with this new 1958 Plymouth if you want to badly enough. You've never had a better story to tell. And you have the outstanding demonstration to make because the new Plymouth itself is a wonderful salesman if given a chance. Now, we've greatly expanded our Plymouth manufacturing facilities so that you'll receive faster, quicker service on stock orders and on those all-important priority sold orders. And because of these expanded facilities, right now, your inventory of new cars consists of the very best possible mix of models and body styles. Today, our field organization is a flexible, hard-hitting, and experienced force. Our zone, regional, and district managers have as their number one purpose to help you sell and deliver the new 1958 Plymouth in greater volume than ever before. Now, all of these marketing factors are working for you today. And they favor more sales gains for Plymouth dealerships and Plymouth salesmen of all automobile dealers. The vast majority of the Plymouth dealers are sitting in the happiest position because you have double protection. You have a low price entry combined with a medium or a high price entry, giving you a spread in the market, which enables a smart salesman to fit a new car into the size of any buyer's pocketbook. But unless you bring in a customer, his pocketbook and your stock of new cars are worthless to you. It's putting your heart and your head together to contact and to tell your story to potential buyers that makes the difference. And you know as well as I do that contacts find prospects. Prospects become customers. So program your sales day. Systematically schedule your established quota of personal contacts, direct mail, telephone calls, demonstrations, and appraisals. And then make them every day. These sales efforts are always necessities, and they'll always pay off for you. And they'll make the year ahead better than the year past. By using your head to develop sales contacts and by putting your heart in this positive sales story, I know you will have a prosperous and satisfying life as a salesman of the new 1958 Plymouth. And thank you very much.
Thank you, Byron, and we're very honored to have you with us today. And now, for you gentlemen out there, I know that you're all very anxious to hear the name of the winner of our big door prize, that great Savoy two-door hardtop. So come on out here, Bob and Alice, and let's find out who the winner is.
Got it.
Yeah, got it? Did you get a hold of...
Suspense is killing me. This is worse than the Academy Awards.
Well, you're not even in this contest. What are you worrying about?
That's what I said. It's just like the Academy Awards.
Okay, now let's find out.
I just talked to Mr. Howard Petrie in Charlotte, North Carolina.
Charlotte, North Carolina.
They're having a wonderful meeting there.
All right, now give us the name of the winner.
It's Mr. Cheryl Joyner.
Wonderful, Mr. Joyner. Congratulations to you, and I know you'll be happy in that great two-door Savoy hardtop.
Well, where he works.
Yeah, where does he work, by the way? Yes, we want to know the dealer's
name. Dean's Motor Company in Nashville, North Carolina.
The Soda Plymouth dealer, Dean's Motor. Wonderful.
Hey, Mr. Joyner, just remember, when you drive into your friendly Plymouth dealer for service, it'll be you. So lubricate under the car, too, huh? I want to tell you, Jack, you've not only made me, Mr. Joyner, happy, but I've really enjoyed this myself today. I'm really impressed. You know, I've seen some great Plymouth cars and heard some terrific sales ideas. And I'm proud to be part of the organization. I don't see how Plymouth can miss in 1958. And from what I've heard this afternoon, you have a terrific new car to sell. It's going to give me great confidence to know that on my television show, I'll be speaking for a product that has everything that has been said about it today. And I'll do everything in my power to bring him into you. If you take over from there, we'll be ahead for keeps. I'll be seeing a lot more of you real soon.
Thank you, Robert. Thank you very much, Bob. And gentlemen, we've covered a lot of important ground here today. And everything we've talked about points to just one conclusion. That Plymouth, the star of the forward look, is more competitive than ever. Never before has your pricing structure been so advantageous, all up and down the line. And you've seen your cars are priced within a few dollars of the competition. and in a great many cases are actually lower. The same money buys any low-priced car. The smart money buys Plymouth. This is the opportunity that we've been waiting for. Nothing can stop the greatest of all Plymouths now. And gentlemen, if you have the determination, as I'm sure you do, nothing can stop you either. Your number one job is selling Plymouth in volume and at a profit. So let's remember and use the facts that we've given you this afternoon, and I'm positive you'll make 1958 one of the most profitable and successful years in your history. So now... Now speaking for Chrysler Corporation's number one car, Plymouth, the star of the forward look is our whole gang.
So long for now, gang. You got the prices, you got the product this year. The competition can't put up, you make them shut up.
And remember, the same money buys any low-priced car, but the smart money buys Plymouth.
We'll be working for you each week, and Climax and Shower of Stars doing our best to help you do your best.
And fellas, remember, the new deluxe wagon is ready for delivery right now. Bye, everybody. Remember, you're selling the lowest priced hardtop in America.
And friends, we'll see you each week for Plymouth on Top Tunes and New Talender.
And fellas, go out after those conquest sales and hit competition where it really hurts them.
Goodbye, everybody. And remember, you have a date with the angels every week.
And our number one job is the same as everybody's number one job, Plymouth. Remember the traffic builder, $500 a month for life beginning Monday.
I'll be doing my best for you Sunday night. We'll even have Dinah Shore driving to Plymouth. Chicken.
Good luck and good selling. Our number one job is to sell the number one car of the corporation, Plymouth.
Thank you for being with us this afternoon, gentlemen. This is the end of our special sales meeting. I'm confident that the facts you've learned today will pay off in greater sales for each of you. Goodbye and good luck.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you'll forgive me for stepping out of character for a really big moment, one I've been eagerly awaiting for weeks. For the many of you who have asked, what will the leader do next, I'm thrilled to present Plymouth's proud reply. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment.
Leading every way. So
big, beautiful new Plymouth, and it's simply wonderful.
Star of the forward look.
This is the luxurious four-door sedan. Isn't the new grille beautiful? Everything about this new Plymouth is years ahead.
Plymouth Suburban is the biggest station wagon of them all, designed for any kind of a job. It has more new, exclusive features than any other station wagon in the low-priced field. A wonderful car to own and drive.
And here's the new Plymouth convertible, just like mine. Never before has so much beauty and riding fun been built into any car. Just drive one.
Yes, sir. One look, one ride, and you'll agree. There's no catching Plymouth now.
Plymouth really is ahead for keeps.
Plymouth, car that's ahead for keeps. Car that's ahead for keeps. Plymouth, star of the forward love.
Sometimes you don't see what you think you see. Actually, there is only one girl in this picture. The reason you see several is because of a neat trick with mirrors. Tricks are used to create an impression or illusion. But there are no tricks about the new Plymouth. It's exactly as you see it. America's most advanced styled car. Its clean, uncluttered beauty stands as a fitting symbol of automobile styling perfection. From impressive new front end, with that custom car luxury look, along its low, sweeping silver dart lines, here is styling that will stay new for years to come. And only Plymouth in its field has the riding superiority of torsion air suspension, the most advanced complete suspension system in use today. It's yours at no extra cost in every new Plymouth. Now add to this all of Plymouth's many other sensational new features and you'll see why there's no catching Plymouth now. Plymouth is ahead for keeps. And remember, be sure to see your Plymouth dealer tomorrow for your entry blank in Plymouth's gigantic Money Ahead contest. The grand prize is $500 a month for the rest of your life. And you may be the winner. Dreams come true. This is the year to own the car designed for you. The star of the forward look. Plymouth for 1958. Put you money ahead when you buy it, when you drive it, and when it's time to trade again. And here's why. Plymouth's years ahead engineering features like this revolutionary torsion air suspension system are standard equipment. Plymouth gives you proven economy and durability. Established by the 1957 Mobil Gas Economy Run and Plymouth's recent 58,000-mile test run, more than twice the distance around the world. And Plymouth is styled for the future. You'll get more trade-in dollars tomorrow for this car that cost you less today. So make 1958 your year to own and drive this beautiful new Money Ahead Plymouth for 58 at your Plymouth dealers now. Thank you, and Happy New Year, everyone!
I just want to remind you there are only a few weeks left in Plymouth's Big Money Ahead contest. It closes midnight, January 26th. Go to your Plymouth dealer right away and get your official entry blank. You just may win yourself $500 a month for life.
Got a date with an angel, gonna meet her at 7. Got a date with an angel, and I'm on my way to heaven.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Plymouth dealer invites you to watch the Lawrence Welk program, Top Tunes and New Talent, on this same network. Tom Kennedy speaking. Good night, everybody.
And a pleasant good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We welcome you to Champagne Music Time, Top Tunes and New Talent.
It's good to get back home.
My goodness, what's that?
Something new has been added. What a beaut!
Something new has been added. Here's a happy couple welcoming spring with a brand new Plymouth convertible. The car that gives you more of everything you want. More style, more engineering, more fun and excitement, more to be proud of. And all because Plymouth builds so much more into its cars. Just look how long and low this baby is, how she hugs the ground, begging to take off to all the places you want to go. Sure, it costs more to build it that way. And it costs more to build Plymouth's torsionnaire ride. It costs more to build Plymouth's full vision windshield that curves around, up, and back. It costs more to build the added safety of Plymouth's total contact brakes. And yet, the surprising fact is, this Plymouth costs you less to buy. This Plymouth is the lowest priced V8 convertible in the low price three. So you see your Plymouth dealer tomorrow.
Plymouth costs more to build.
But costs you less to buy.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's an important announcement for all of you who entered Plymouth's fabulous $500 a month for life contest. Now next week, on this very show, 1 week from tonight, Top Tunes, a new talent, we're going to name the grand prize winner. Someone, somewhere in these United States is going to win $500 a month for the rest of his or her life. And it might be you. So you be with us next week for sure, will you? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
1, 2, 3. The big three and the low price three today are Plymouth. The cars that cost more to build because there's so much more built into them. Yet Plymouth costs you less to buy. Star number one, this big, handsome Plymouth Suburban with style, ride, roominess, and advanced features that can't be matched by Wells. The Plymouth Savoy. Here is America's lowest priced two-door hardtop. One look, one ride, and you know there's more built into it. And yet this Plymouth costs you up to $104 less than its competitors. And here is star number three, that dashing Plymouth convertible. A most luxurious convertible in its field, and yet this is the lowest priced V8 convertible in the low price three. Convertible, the hardtop, the station wagon. The big three in the low price three. You see your Plymouth dealer tomorrow for the model of your choice. Thank you, Ben.
And folks, we hope you'll visit your Plymouth dealer real soon and drive the finest car, the best car, and the low price for you. Folks, right now, our good friend Lou Crosby is going to produce a play. The scene almost anywhere, our characters, a boy and a girl, and an idea set to music.
America today, people are looking at that new Plymouth, and here's what they're saying.
Today's best buy in an automobile, tomorrow's best trade in an automobile. Plymouth, Plymouth, definitely best buy, best trade in the low price street. Plymouth.
Ah, it's right, friends. Plymouth is unquestionably today's best buy and tomorrow's best trade. And the reason? Because that Plymouth gives you so much more car for your money today and more money for your car tomorrow. For example, Plymouth gives you modern silver dart styling, and underneath that sleek exterior is this rugged chassis with a full 118-inch wheelbase. And regardless of the model you choose or the price you pay, famous torsionaire ride is standard equipment on every new Plymouth. And only Plymouth has total contact brakes, the surest stopping brakes in the industry today. Folks, no matter how you figure it, you get more for your money in a Plymouth, and your years ahead Plymouth with silver dart styling, naturally, will bring you a higher trade-in price. So, you see your Plymouth dealer tomorrow, and remember,
today's best buy in an automobile, tomorrow's best trade in an automobile. Plymouth, Plymouth, definitely best buy, best trade in the low price street.
Folks, when you buy a new car these days, you've got to stretch your dollar to get more for your money. But the one sure way to get more car for your money today and more money for your car at trade-in time is to see your Plymouth dealer and let him show you why. In the low-priced field, Plymouth is today's best buy, tomorrow's best trade. And the reason? Plymouth builds so much more into its car, in engineering, in styling, and in riding comfort. And this is why Plymouth brings a higher price at trade-in time. And yet this Plymouth hardtop costs up to $104 less than its competitors. So remember, for today's best buy and tomorrow's best trade, buy a Plymouth.
Plymouth, definitely best buy, best trade in the low price tree. Plymouth.
Thank you. Yes, friends, see your Plymouth dealer for the best car and the best buy in the low price tree. This past hour, champagne music, and our special guests. We'll be with you again next Saturday with your Dodge dancing party. We do hope we can have the pleasure of having many of you folks with us. And now, pleasant good night, and drive carefully. Good night.
Travel arrangements for the Top Tunes, the New Talent Show, are made for United Airlines, the radar line, famous for its DC-7 red carpet service, non-stop, coast to coast. When your children are ready for college, will college be ready for them? Their future depends on what we do today. Help the college of your choice now. Be sure to watch the new Betty White Show every week on this same network, presented by the Plymouth Dealers of America. Top Tunes, the new talent, has been selected for viewing by our armed forces overseas. Lou Crosby speaking. Good night, everybody!
Live from Television City in Hollywood, Plymouth, the star of The Forward Look and the Plymouth Dealers of America, presents IMAX. Tonight, starring Johnny Desmond, Pavan, James Dunn, Gil Stratton, Jackie Coogan, and now your host for Plymouth, Bill Lundy.
Good evening. Tonight on Climax, the fabulous, glittering city of Las Vegas provides the setting for a gripping drama of fear and pursuit. It's set to the tempo of rhythm, song. Now on Climax, Keep Me in Mind, written especially for Climax by Jerry Davis.
And now for a moment, let's step into the world of fashion.
Fashion comes this vision of loveliness as Mary Costa models a gown designed especially for the occasion.
Thank you.
you, Bill. You know, styling is important in clothes, but it's just as important in automobiles, too. Now, I think you men will agree with that just as much as the ladies. There's a world of difference in automobile designing these days, but there's no question which car in the low-price field is ahead for keeps in beauty and in style. It's the magnificent Plymouth for 1958. Here is tomorrow's styling. Only a promise in other cars, but yours today in every new Plymouth. Just look at it. Your new Plymouth starts with this new, wide, impressive front end and sweeps back along the side with new, exclusive silver dart styling. It's long, low, clean, and uncluttered. No hastily added pieces of chrome that you've seen on some of the other new cars. Plymouth's new control tower tail lights are both functional and distinctive, adding to the safety that is yours when you drive a Plymouth. Your Plymouth for 1958 is designed as a complete expression of years ahead styling that will still be years ahead for years to come. Just one look, one ride, and you'll agree Plymouth is really ahead for keeps in styling and in engineering too. There's just no catching Plymouth now. Visit your Plymouth dealers tomorrow. See, drive, and buy the star of the forward look, Plymouth for 1958.
Brought to you by Plymouth, star of the forward look, and the Plymouth dealers of America.